Hi YouTube, hi world. I am Melissa, and of course I should probably do more of a formal introduction. I'm actually at the doctor's office at my RE, about to go in for my beta HCG blood draw. This is our second IVF attempt, but our first frozen embryo transfer. Let me go ahead and show you the clinic. If I can. I don't think I can turn the camera around while I'm recording on this phone, unfortunately, so never mind. Let me see if I can have you guys see it. Probably not. But I'm definitely nervous. This is just my monitoring clinic that I'm at. I go to a clinic in New York. I give more information on that in another video. But this is my local clinic that I do all my blood work and ultrasounds. And then they send those results. I have to have everything done by 9:30 in the morning, and they send the results to my clinic in New York. And then I get my results in the afternoon, praying that everything works well. Today is 10 days past a 3-day transfer of one embryo. I did this New Year's weekend, Friday before New Year's weekend, secretly, no one knew, other than me and my husband, and just one other person, and we wanted to keep it that way because our first transfer, those results were really, really devastating. We transferred 2 embryos at that time, so wish me luck. Hey everybody, so as you can see, I'm wearing a new sweater, new outfit, as you can see. I didn't get my beta results the same day. It was Monday, January 8th that I went in that morning. I was expecting my results sometime between 1 and 3 o'clock from my clinic. And 3 o'clock came and went. That was my lunch hour, and I was just waiting and waiting in the car for the phone call. Just anxious all day. By 5-6 o'clock, I hadn't heard anything. I went ahead and emailed them, my reproductive endocrinologist on the portal. They let me know that they didn't get my results, which was shocking. I have never not gotten results. So at that point, I called the local doctor that I'm monitoring with here in Central Florida and called their emergency line. Of course, it was an emergency, but I still wanted to know. They just, answer service basically just took the message and said they'd send it back to me. So it was driving me crazy all day. And so I could have honestly just bought a test and, just tested at home that night. But I was like, you know what? I'd rather just hear it from them. So Tuesday morning, which was the 9th, I just woke up out of bed, basically just shot up out of bed out of nowhere, and like something happened, and I looked at my phone and I saw that I just missed a phone call and it was private, and I automatically knew it was my clinic in New York, and they left a voicemail. The voicemail was over 30 seconds, and in my opinion, don't take this for fact, but in my opinion, if a voicemail is like a little bit over like 35 seconds, usually it's a positive result and they're trying to tell you to come back and let you know what you need to do. If it's a negative beta or negative result, it's usually pretty quick. But still, that's not 100% science, that's just my experience. So I listened to the voicemail and the nurse basically let me know that the beta was positive. So we are pregnant. I hope you can see. I hope they focus pretty well. I don't know what order I just put these in, but they are like a week apart. So yes, listened to the voicemail and I woke my husband up immediately out of his sleep, let him listen to the voicemail, and I just cried my little eyes out. And my first beta was 82 and my second beta was 182. Or I think my first beta was 81, and then my second beta 2 days later was, which was that following Wednesday, was 182. so far so good. We decided to keep it, you know, between us, keep it very limited and small. Our family members, our friends do not know at this time. They will know by the time this post goes up. But right now they do not know. We're doing our best to wait until the heartbeat, as we didn't get to experience hearing the heartbeat with our missed miscarriage. So congratulations to us. I'm so happy. And I will be updating you. Today is Tuesday the 16th? So it's been a little bit over a week. And tomorrow I have my first ultrasound at 5 weeks. Some of my apps say today I'm 5 weeks, some of them say tomorrow I'm 5 weeks, I don't know, but I'll have my appointment tomorrow for my first ultrasound, and I'll see the fetal pole in the sac, that's the goal, and I will update you guys then.